Hey guys, I'm Devashish and today's video is about the trek essentials that we need to carry in the high altitude treks. So there are n number of ways of making a checklist and keeping your stuff which you need for a high altitude trek. What I basically do is I divide all my things in three categories. One is the things which I need during daytime. Second, the things which I need during the night time. And the third is the accessories which you will need every now and then. Now coming to the first category, the things which you need during a day. The first and the foremost thing is a rucksack. So if you're going for a 3-day trek, then you know your rucksack can be a 45 liter. Then if you're going from 4 to 5 days, it can be a 55 to 65 liter. And this one here is a North Face Terra 65, which is a 65 liter rucksack and has a good amount of space to carry all your essentials. Next is the summit bag, which is a small bag of a capacity of around 10 to 15 liters. This is needed if you're going for a summit trek and you know you can carry your stuff like a water bottle, some dry fruits, a chocolate and you know some packed parathas for lunch. So this is also a must. Now the third thing is a poncho and a rain cover. So in the mountains you never know when the weather changes. So it's always good to have these things handy. Now coming to personal clothing which you need during the daytime, I'll start with the shoes because you know while you're trekking you're basically walking and you must have a very comfortable pair of shoes. You know, a high ankle shoe is preferred because it supports your ankle. The shoe must have a very good grip and it must be very comfortable for your feet. Then you need a good quick dry pants. If you're going for a longer trek, then you can take a pair of pants, and then if you're going for a small trek, just a weekend trek, then one pant is enough. For upper body clothing, if it's a summer trek, then a full sleeves quick dry t-shirt is good to go. You can have a pair of them. If there is collar, then it's better. If it's a winter trek, then you'll have to add a layer of fleece. If you don't have a fleece, then you can go for a good sweatshirt. Coming to the last few things which you will definitely need during the daytime. First is a trekking hat. A trekking hat is very essential because when you are going in the higher altitude, there's a lot of sunburn which happens and this saves you from that. Another thing is, particularly if you're going for a snow trek, then you must have a very good pair of polarized sunglasses. Sunglasses because you know the rays are reflected from the snow and they really hit you hard on the eyes and you'll have headaches and all sorts of problems, and even it causes snow blindness. Even if you wear specs, like I wear specs, so I have this custom made polarized glass which has a power of about -5, so you can, if you're trekking frequently, you can obviously go for these sunglasses. And the last thing, you know, which generally trekkers forget and then they keep on asking other trekkers about it, is a water bottle. At least 1 liter water bottle is a must because you know when you're trekking for long distances you don't get a lot of water supplies in between, so you know at least you should have 1 liter of water bottle. Two more things which will come in use during the daytime is a trek pole. Though it's an accessory, but it saves 40% of your energy, so it's very helpful. The second thing is, if you drink a lot of water and you think 1 liter of water bottle is not enough for you, you can carry this hydration bag. You can just put it in your rucksack and its capacity is up to 2 liters, so you can have more water. Now coming to the second category of things, which is the things which you need during the night time. So this is a very important category because you know at night time, even if it's summer or it's a winter trek, it gets very cold. So you have to be very specific about the clothes you keep for the nights, and they have to be, you know, keep separately in your rucksack. So you must have a pair of thermals. So thermals is the first layer. So during winters you need to have around 4 to 5 layers of clothing, and during summers 2 to 3 layers of clothing is enough. So the first layer is the thermals. Then you know, coming to the upper body, over the thermals you need a good warm t-shirt. Then you need to have one layer of fleece. Then you need to have this down jacket. You need to have a padded jacket. It can be a down-filled jacket or a synthetic jacket, but we prefer it to be a down jacket because down jackets are more warmer. For the lower body, you will be needing two layers of clothing. So first will be your thermals and second will be a warm lower along with woolen socks. For your head, you will have a woolen cap, and for your hands, you will have a pair of gloves. Now during the night time, one very important thing is a head torch, because there will be no lights around your campsite because there is no electricity. So everyone must have a head torch, and even inside the tent, you know, it gets very difficult to find your stuff if you don't have a head torch. So this is a must. Now the third category of things which will come in use every now and then. So first you must have a kit bag where you'll carry some toiletries. So you must have a sunscreen 30 SPF and above. Then you must have a face wash, a liquid hand wash, toothbrush, toothpaste, and a moisturizer. If you like, you can also carry a hand towel. And this one thing is very important, which is a toilet roll. So basically, whenever you're going for a trek, you won't get washrooms there. There will be either toilet tents or you'll have to go out. So if you're using toilet tents, then toilet tents are dry. They are dry toilets. You cannot use much water there. So you can use this tissue rolls. You can also carry a pair of slippers. One more important thing in this category is a personal medical kit. Though you'll be traveling with companies, so they will be providing you a medical kit, but then everybody has a medical history. If you have something specific, then you can carry that as well, and it's always good to have some first aid with yourself. We will be making a elaborate video about medical kits as well. If you find the video helpful, then do hit the subscribe button for more such videos on trekking and mountaineering tips.